what happens in our subsequent meetup will be a direct consequence of what you guys tell us. What is it that you want to see in these meetups? These meetups necessarily need to be of some value, because otherwise you've got the numbers you keep will be getting. So we need to hear your voice. We have that, the way that should be done. So please go through that first.
Basically, doing that stuff. But I need to understand consumers, and I need to understand customers, which is why I'm actually coming from the publishing part of the business. I understand how to make games for marketing, and how to market, and how to distribute, and understand how to buy them. And that really was what I was doing here. So that's a quick background, and if we can get the Ajay Khanna, yeah, you'll see it on the slide. It'll be big and nice and big. Cool. Okay, so quick show of hands. Can I just who from here is from a development background? Yeah. Okay. Console, PC, or mobile? Console, PC. Okay, and mobile. Okay, fine. Number of years of experience in the industry, so less than 10? Okay. Anyone here with more than 10 years in the game business? Okay, cool. Cool. That's good. Okay, fine. So a nice little mix.
My name is Anandu Banerjee. I'm from Lakshmi. I take
Hi, I'm with the Vishesh Nagy and Lakshmi is the product manager.
I'm Janet Singh. I'm with Lakshmi and I'm taking the product.
Yes, I'm Shiraz Miller. I'm from Lakshmi and I'm with the product.
So, yes,
what's your name?
Shiraz.
They actually have a very good scheme now, right?
Yeah, that's
what. How much? 50 rupees per handset or $50?
Yeah, it's $50.
Yeah. Very good.
Hi, I'm Chaitanya. I head business for Jump Games in India. and we have games like Mente and Google in the real scheme. So you can game across platforms.
I'm Arvind. I run Paradoxical Games. I'm a designer slash programmer slash writer slash etc.
I'm Saurabh. I'm an accident at a 3D animation.
Hi, I'm Vishwath, Vishwath Kalan, and I'm a student of computer science.
Hi, I'm Apoorv Gupta. I head Empowered.m. We make smartphone games.
Vijay, also from Empowered.
I'm Himanshu and I'm an iPhone game developer.
Pretty good.
I'm pretty good.
Alright. Okay, let's get rolling. So, I've talked about the first slide. I've actually talked about the second slide also. That's a quick overview. So, let's get straight into the meat of it. Okay. I'm going to talk about a couple of things. First of all, why do you even need a publisher, okay, in this modern day and age? The second piece is actually the title of the presentation, which is pitching to the publisher. And then we're going to throw it open to a little bit of a Q&A, okay? So this is your opening quiz. Who is a publisher? A publisher is either someone who sucks the light out of us poor developers, who squeezes us so tight till we get completely, okay? And there's nothing left. And he takes 80% of the revenue. I mean, what shit, man. Or a publisher is someone who actually provides a valuable service. Okay. Does he actually enable the guys who want to build games to build games? And does he actually let someone who is good at marketing and distribution and licensing and talking to the legal guys and the commercial and the cash flow, let them handle that? So which of it? Quick show of hands. Is the answer A or B? No, show of hands. Come on. A. Who's in favor of A? Okay. I bet you there's more guys than that in favor of A, okay? All of us inside say it is A. Okay. Well, I assume the rest of us are saying B. And I think for the record, let me also officially cast my vote in favor of B. So look, the reality is that they do provide a valuable service, and the only testimony I can give you to that is that publishers have been around for a long time. They've been around in book publishing, they've been around in music publishing, they're around in every form of entertainment. And the reason why the publisher model has survived is because they do provide this valuable service. Okay? And the simplest thing I can say is the developer guys are good at developing, the publishing guys are good at publishing, and a successful marriage is actually a very good mix of the two. Okay. So really, if you look at the role, any good entertainment property, not necessarily games, there are three parts to it. Okay. One is the whole idea generation piece. The second is the actual building of the production. You know, if it's a game, building it on a certain platform. And then the third is deployment, which ranges from everything from, you know, quality assurance, testing it on various platforms, porting it to platforms, to actually stamping it on disks, putting it on a server somewhere, translating it to different languages, getting it out into retail, putting up the posters, getting it on the radio, so on and so forth. Now, if you look at typically what the publisher can help a developer with, there are three parts. Obviously, the middle piece, yes, very much is done by the developer. But even the whole idea creation part, a publisher can many times help you with a licensed property. So for example, many of the most successful games in the world have actually been from a licensed property. And those rights are typically held by a publisher. So you can actually work with a publisher to get that. The second important feature is they provide you finance. So if you only had to work off your own steam and try to build games, I can guarantee you the number of games produced in a year would fall by about 50%, because the individual resources of a developer are always very limited. The second piece is on the production side. usually publishers have experienced teams who work with you. And these are teams who, with many, many years of experience, 20-year-old, 25-year-old veterans, it's very unlikely that a small developer certainly would ever be able to afford a full-time person of that experience to come and work with you. Okay? Even as a consultant, many times you would not be able to get this caliber of people to work for you. So they actually provide you the ongoing critique that you need to handle your business. The third piece, of course, is all that stupid operation stuff, which frankly we're not interested in. Getting the disk, stamping it, localizing it, box artwork, all that complete crap, and getting it into the market, and then finally getting the money from the retailer. Okay, and in case you don't know this, retailers worldwide operate on minimum 60 to 90 days credit. Okay, so you sell the product to them, if it sells, they pay you after 90 days. If it doesn't sell, it's going to come back right to you. Okay, and the other important point to remember is, in many cases on many of the platforms, Xbox 360, PS3, the royalty that you pay the platform holder, which is quite significant. So you're paying a royalty to Sony, you're paying a royalty to Microsoft. That is paid when the product is produced, X factory. So on a typical $50 game, you could be paying $12 as royalty to Microsoft, okay? The minute it is produced and shipped, if it goes and comes back, that money is gone, wiped out. And that inventory risk is hundreds of millions of dollars, certainly tens of millions of dollars, okay? And that risk basically is taken away from you. It's taken by the publisher. Okay, so I think I've sold you on the proposition, right? They do provide an important role. Love them or leave them, you have to live with them. So when you pitch a game to a publisher, what exactly is he looking for? The English word for it is a great proposition. Okay, now what is a great proposition? Really, I'll try and break it up. He's looking for some kind of new IP that's going to excite the market, that is going to drive his platform forward, that he can say, look, this is the iconic game for my platform. Okay, so, you know, if you look at any of the platform holders, whether it's Sony, whether it's Microsoft, they always have a key title which they believe is what is driving their platform forward. The second piece they want is longevity. All it means is that you cannot build a game which is a one-shot flash in the pan. The way games make money for everyone, for the publisher as well as for you, is if they have legs. Okay, basically you can build a franchise out of them, you can launch a second game, you can launch a third game, you can launch many versions of the same game. That really is what they're looking for. So if I filter that into three action points that you need to remember when you pitch to someone, it's basically concept, developer, and game. Those are the three things that, so at the end of this presentation, if you only go back with three words in your mind, those are the three words: concept, developer, game. Therefore, your role as a publisher, this is something that, as a developer, this is something that doesn't come naturally to developers. We're not, as a group, we are not into selling ourselves. We like building our games, hum log mast rehte hain, and we're very happy doing that. Trying to push, oversells ourselves to someone is not something we like. But it's something you have to do. The things that they will look for in terms of concept is it a strong concept? Certain words they use. Have you done your analysis? Is the research right? What is the team like? Do they have credibility, right? And in terms of the game, is it new and different, but is it not so different that people completely don't understand this game? Because that's the other risk. Don't try to, you know, go off the cliff, right? You have to find that edge where you're balancing stuff and you're going forward. When you're talking about the concept to the publisher, you actually have to have a lot of energy in you, okay? You need to have a lot of visualization. You need to really bring that creative piece that all of us as developers have inside. And a lot of that is based on the homework that you do. Is it fitting to the publisher? Each publisher has a genre, okay? So, you know, if you're going to talk to Disney, they are in a particular genre. They're not going to make the next first-person shooter game. right? So you need to pick your battles very carefully. You need to look at all the research that's out there in terms of the genre. What is the history of first-person shooters? What is the history of sports simulation? You need to look at the other properties that are out there and find a fit with the publisher. And that's really how you're going to get to the right concept. Then you need to talk about yourselves. So one is, what is that big idea? The second piece is, who are we? Who is the developer? Remember one thing, the publisher is not hiring the concept. He's hiring the team of people who are building the game. That is really what he's buying into. And so, few key words that they all look for. What is the size of the team? What is their experience? Have they sold anything before? What's the quality review? So on and so forth. Is this the A team? You know, are all the key team members locked in? Because many times they're very scared that, okay, I've got a great artist, lead artist, but you know what? He can walk across the road to someone else tomorrow. What's the technology we use? What is our strength? Is it in AI? Is it in art? What is the weakness of the team? You know, is it such a small team that it's going to take a very long development cycle? In which case, who knows what's going to happen 2 years from now? Studio someone who actually has a financial backing, right? Are they strong enough to survive this development cycle, or are they just hand to mouth? You know, are they just sort of living off? And basically, that's who they are going to buy into. The third piece is the game. In terms of basics, what does it look like? What is the design? Does it leverage the strengths of the platform that you're building it for, whether it's a PC game or whether it's a console game or whether it's even a game for a tablet or a smartphone? What are the key hooks within the game? What are those points when you can actually see that this is a sort of inflection? Get in and play till that point to be hooked. In terms of the current status, where are you exactly? Is it just an idea in someone's mind, or have you actually put down some work behind it? Have you built a prototype? Have you done some key programming? Have you built some key art? What is the plan? If you haven't, you may not have built all of it. In fact, you certainly wouldn't have built all of it. But do you actually have a plan? Do you actually have a say, look, this guy is going to work 3 man months, and by this time we'll have 100 art assets completed in this time frame? They want you to have thought of all these issues. You're going to ask them for money. Okay, after all, that is one of the things that a publisher does for you. Okay, they do provide you milestone based advances. Okay, now the question is, don't ask for the moon and don't bullshit them. Everyone in this industry knows production costs, and they know production costs in India, they know production costs globally. So it's all benchmark. So figure out what is your fixed cost, what is your variable cost, and really what is it you need to produce the game within a realistic time frame. On the legal side, I think the discussion is about IP ownership. You know, do we own the IP, do you own the IP, you know, which platforms do we exploit, who owns the residual rights? You know, in many cases you have agreements which says all the residual rights belong to me. So who knows, 20 years from now, if there's some intergalactic platform that is built using laser beams, those rights for those games belong to the publisher, not to you. Okay, so you know, it's sort of interesting. I remember 10 years ago, some of the best studios in India have made success stories out of going out and buying movie rights for Hollywood games. Okay, because in those days people were licensing their Hollywood games for PC and console production, and they didn't even know what a mobile phone Java game was. So someone just said, well, yeah, let's just put those rights off and go and license it off. You need to ask for what you want. Okay, so be prepared to state up front. Don't be pussyfooting around saying, acha, you tell us what you want. A publisher likes someone who knows his mind, but at the same time be flexible. Okay, the publisher will usually come with his own policy framework, which is to say, look, broadly speaking, here are the rights that we keep, here are the rights that we don't keep. But it's never cast in black and white. Okay, there are always things that can be negotiated, things that can be pushed, and those are the points where you will have a discussion around. To me, when you are selling, there is a basically a priority list of tools that you need to walk into that meeting with. Okay, and I've actually ranked them from the most important to the least important. Of course, this is entirely dependent on your capability as a team, as a group, and your resources. Okay, if you can go with a prototype, okay, there is nothing better than sitting down in a meeting, opening your laptop, and actually having the game run there. Even if it is one level, one build, that's it. It will just completely sell the idea. Okay? And there's nothing better that proves your capability as a team, your ideas, and it gives you the look and feel. If you can't do that, second best option, go with a video presentation. Okay? Video presentation you can do in-house with your art team, less requirements on the engineering side. If you can't do that, just go with an ordinary PowerPoint presentation. But the way to do the PowerPoint presentation is make it like a movie trailer. So I don't know if you've ever sat, all of us have been to any of the conferences at Fiki Frames or at any of the things. If you see some of the guys, the really good developers who come and talk about their games and they do their reviews, you see the presentation style that they do. It's all visuals. It's all visuals, music, sound. And it takes you through almost the storyline. And the storyline is as if you were playing the game. Right? So opening scene, cut shot, here's what happens. Dandana, moving on to the next one. If you can't do that, you do what I do, which is you come with a white presentation slide with a few logos on the side, one lazy man's option. I apologize for that. And you try and pass some time with a few people. I personally don't think this may sell, although in this occasion it may sell, I don't know. Okay. If I had music and some sound, it would have been more entertaining. But that's it. But I think this really is the most important advice I can give you in terms of what you do when you're pitching to the publisher. You only have that half an hour, 1 hour meeting. And if you can get there with that 2 minutes of a prototype, 5 minutes of a prototype, that's it.